God, Salamangreat Great just destroyed this event, and that's actually kind of hilarious to me, and I don't know why. Budget? Budget. Possibly? Maybe. Master everyone, crap out, subscribe, and so you guys don't miss out on more excellent content. So, we had a PPG this past weekend, and these results are not what I really expected. So, the breakdown here, we had two Salamangreat Great decks in top 8, which that's a lot higher than we normally see around these parts, actually. Salad's usually out here struggling to get any sort of real competition or any real stance. I've seen this deck make multiple top 16s at events, but it always kind of falls short in that top 8 category. And then we had two Shadal Dogmatica down here. Does this surprise anybody? Anybody surprised by this? Anybody? Nah, okay. We also had one Dinosaur in top cut. It's Dinosaur, man. Like, there's nothing else to say about that. And we had Hunter Lloyd here coming in with the sauce. All right, he played Adamancipator Kids, or Praying Kids Adamancipator. We'll show that list here in a second for you guys, but Adamancipator's back. We had one Invoke Dogmatica, actually. So, standard Alistair without the Shadal package. And then we had Zubrigade. So, we're getting some hang time here with Tri-Brigade in the top cut, which actually is a good thing, but this is a very interesting spread here across the metagame. So, let's dig on into the deck list here. So, we have the basic Salad list here that ended up winning the event. We are on 2 Will, which is actually pretty standard, I would say, nowadays. 2 Rage, 2 Roar, Triple Desires. A lot of people out there are still like, I don't want to play Desires in my deck. I understand. You compensate, though. The card says draw 2, all right? It's really good in Salad, all right? Outside of that, we're also playing the one. Is that Prohibit Snake? Prohibit Snake's finally getting some love back in the metagame here, so that's actually exciting. Also, this everybody's Cyvers, right? So means we get access to Firewall Dragon in this deck. That's really good. Also, we're on 2 Flame Buffalo, or excuse me, Triple Flame Buffalo, 2 Lady Debug for this build. Triple Parallel Exceed. Nothing else too crazy to say about this. Honestly, in terms of what Salad would look like in terms of modern Yu-Gi-Oh, Sandiago has it down here. Alright, so I don't have any complaints here about this. This is pretty straightforward. Enjoy your free firewall abuse when you can get it every other game, actually. So, yeah. Hey! Salamangreat took it down, all right? When you get a W this nice, you enjoy it, all right? Next up here for list, we have Michael Bond's Shadal Invoked. And with the splice of Dogmatica in here as well. I swear, Super Poly's become a norm in this deck. We're maxing out on just one Ecclesia, one Floor, and then one Punishment is our sub-engine for this. We have, I think Ariel's become a norm in this deck now, this point as well. I don't see, there's nothing too particularly spicy about this. This is pretty standard for what I would expect for modern day Yu-Gi-Oh! Alright, Dinosaur! Triple Prosperity, we want to make sure that we can filter for our deck options, check. 2 Animador, standard. 2 Ultimate Conductor, that's pretty standard. Nibiru is the hand trap of choice for this deck. I don't see anything too crazy here, except for we're playing, is that the Gizmek in the side deck with a light barrier statue? Yeah, that's interesting. Outside of that, nothing too crazy on this list as well. Now, the sauce. So Hunter Lloyd playing Adamancipator Praying Kids. Man, this literally reminds me of the earliest builds that we saw from this deck. I remember the earlier builds where we were playing just the 3 Roxies and then, you know, 1 or 2 off elements for extensions. This one is playing more on top of that. We have the Dragoon package in here. We are fully utilizing everything that we can in a 44 card package to break boards. Every time I see Hunter play, like, it's always something quite interesting. Hunter's quite the little innovationist out here for this game. So, I like this. Also, the Mad Lad is citing Barkeon. Alright, trap decks? Hey, trap player. No. Not today. Not on Hunter's watch. Alright, I really do like Hunter's List here for what he's actually cooked up for the metagame. So this is actually spicy. I do like this quite a lot. And I do hope that players will look at this list and give this some consideration to play. Because this is what innovation looks like, everybody. Like, this is some exciting stuff. Next up, we have... Oh, boy. Ah, it's Invoke Dogmatica. Oh. So Christian here, I don't see anything too crazy about this. We're on triple Ecclesia. We're doing the one Maximus play standard. We have Schism, triple Ice Dragon Prison in here. Every build I play, I miss Purgatrio. I miss this deck. So yeah, not too much on the crazy shit all package here. We're not crazy like the other builds. This build is still doing the whole shit all package. And by one shit all package, I mean one Schism. All right, like that's all you got to do for basic stuff for this build. So basic stuff here. Next up, oh boy, it's more Invoke Shaddoll. Oh, this one is actually playing the new Shaddoll monster in the deck, though. I think a lot of players have pretty much discounted this, at least from what I've seen on higher competitive tier play. As I'm making this video, I've only seen two builds that have topped the, I guess, larger tournaments that you would call them at this point in time. So that's not a large number of people that are bulking down and wanting to play the new Shaddoll monster. Though it does add plays to it, I think it's cool. I think most of the consent I've heard from players though is you just want to play it in pure Shaddoll. So seeing that it's actually seeing play here in this deck is actually kind of interesting. But alright, also, I'm looking at all these lists and I'm kind of starting to wonder, has a pointer become that much of a staple going forward through events? Because it's kind of what I'm starting to feel as we go through these deck profiles here, is how staple is a pointer for today's metagame. Next up, Tri-Brigade Zoo. So Zoo Brigade, the cool thing with Zoo Brigade is you get off with meaning like three Zodiac monsters and like one Barrage. All right, that's like a four card dedication in your Tri-Brigade deck as it is, right? Like, there's nothing that's hindering you from just going, I'm gonna add in, you know, like four Zoo cards. Now I can sculpt my extra deck to play that Zoo package, and now I get access to Zeus all of a sudden. And that's what? Four extra materials to load up for any Tri-Brigade monster, so now you get to further extend out for extra copies of Shirog. Yeah, that's what free real estate looks like, ladies and gentlemen. That's actually really good. I do like what Zoo Brigade is definitely innovating in these formats, but man, this is not very budget friendly at all, but interesting list. All right, and last but not least here, we had Dylan Williams. That's Salad again? Yeah, that's Salad. We are missing one card down here on the list. I'm not quite sure what that is, but you can kind of filter however you want. You see here, the difference between this list in first place is one Roar, one Rage. No Prohibit Snake, actually. No Lady Debugs in this list. You can compensate, play Lady Debug if you want. Like, you have all sorts of options, man. Like, Salad has always been cool in that regard. If you can go to, like, one extreme, or you can back down and go down here and go through, like, different lines of play for this deck. And I do like that. I think that's probably one of the coolest things that Salad really has had going for it, is just the different lines of play that you can do in terms of deck building. So that's really nice. Dylan definitely showcases that here, that even first to eighth place, both players had the right idea. Now, there were two rogue lists here. So the first one here is Jakari Clark's list. This was on Team Relinquished channel. Garlancho was nice enough and built it for us here. This is basically, is this just Hero Turbo? Is that the Fire Flint lady up there? So two warrior monsters. Man, I really just want to make warrior monsters with this. Huh, so the Fire Flint lady actually gives us access to make Zeus in our hero deck. What? I guess. That's cool. I also see that we don't have to play the expensive adjusted gold package in here. We have access to pretty much the super poly targets that we want. This is actually kind of interesting. Huh. I actually am kind of curious to know what the losses were for this build. Because when you see like Firefront Lady plus Hero, you really just think that they're going to go down the Assault Package. No. We make Big Zoom Monster to attack opponent directly. See, that's the genius of this deck. This is actually interesting. I like this. Also, this is what innovation looks like. This is exciting. And the last list we actually have here is Virtual World. All right, so You know how Virtual World's been going through the infinite evolution lines that it has to constantly endure. Well, good news, everybody. We got another cool build. Also, I see that we're packing in the, see, that's the Buster Blader fusion monster in that extra deck. Yeah, I see we're doing some Muddy Mud Dragon shenanigans with that. That's interesting. Okay, I see you. That's pretty spicy, actually. I like that. See, we also have access to Dragoon. Yeah, you know what you're doing with that. Outside of that, this is pretty standard stuff, actually. Besides, you know, the Buster Blader fusion monster. Virtual World doing shenanigans? I think so. So, guys, what do you think about the breakdown from this event? Smash your love and crap out, subscribe button, leave a comment down below, tell me what you guys think about these awesome lists. And I'll see your beautiful faces back here later on in the day for some cool, awesome content. Peace out, guys. Have a good rest of your day.
Thank you, patrons, for making the ride never truly end. Without you guys' support, well, I would probably be doing Truffle Shuffle videos for a living. Guys, please check out VanCole40 for all of your Cardfight Vanguard content brought to you by MCole40. And if you are looking to pick up singles, check out mcolegames.com for your trading card game needs. Thanks for watching, everybody.